What is going on? Welcome into the channel. So happy to have you here always. My name is Deborah, owner of Purusha Holistic Wellness, and this is another episode of Purusha Intuitive, where we're going to be looking at your energy via the tarot, astrology, and channeled messages. So let's get into it. We are just coming up on a full moon in Scorpio. It's Scorpio season. Happy birthday to anybody who is celebrating this season. I just wish you all the blessings, so much love. I hope you are able to shine and just have a fabulous season. Scorpio energy is all about connecting with what we desire, and partnerships, relationships, dynamics that we have been getting involved in definitely correlate to that, because it really shows what we think we're worthy, what we think we're valuable of. Putting up with different dramas, chaos, conflict, etc. Is it worth it? Is it getting you to where you want to go? Is it leading you towards your success? And as we're seeing more clearly the places that are not, it gives us an opportunity to connect with those desires that I was talking about. New moons are all about setting new intention or readjusting something that's not working. And right now we're in the waning phase of the cycle, of the moon cycle, where it's about releasing, letting go, being mindful, being aware, like I was talking about, of what isn't working and making adjustments accordingly so that you can tap into those things that really feed and nourish your soul. We'll start with an energy cleansing, little blessing for you, little blessing for me. Set the tone, set the vibe for the reading. It's also a really good time to set your own intention. It helps to make personalize these collective readings. They are collective readings, obviously. So use your discernment always. And I do personal readings. I do tarot, astrology, mediumship. I also do energy healing and wellness consultations. So that realignment of mind, body, soul. If you need any support, I would love to assist. Definitely hit me up. All that info is in the description box below. All right, let's get into it. I bless you with pure love and light, pure source energy, pure loving grace. I release anything that is not for your highest and best. Any fears, doubts, insecurities, lack of worth, lack of value, pain, anger, frustration, impatience, overwhelm. Cleanse it and release it from our being so that we may see and understand the messages, the lessons clearly, and help to make me a clear and open channel for the collective. Thank you, Father God, spirit guides, guardian angels, Mama love. So in the astrology, the moon has really been taking a beating for a hot minute right now. There's a lot of water energy. Okay. It's a blessing and a curse. It really does allow us to connect with those more subtler senses, i.e. our intuition. And, you know, to be honest, because we're in Scorpio season, that veil to the spirit world is quite thin. And like I said, it's a blessing and a curse because it gives us insight, but at the same time, it can be really destabilizing, especially if you're not feeling settled in some of the more challenging aspects in your life that are kind of triggering different things. But what spirit's really been highlighting lately is so much of it is a change in perspective, opening up to new ways of seeing, ways of perceiving. It actually is going to diffuse some of those energetic connections, energetic bonds that you've created with these more challenging dynamics in your life. But it doesn't make it any easier on our emotional world and even our ego a little bit, right? Like when things are rubbing us the wrong way, it just makes us feel really like down and out, or questions our value, our validity in what we're choosing. And today Venus is square to, tensely aspected to Saturn. So it does kind of bring in this sense of sadness, wishing things were different, wishing they weren't so difficult, so hard, or they hadn't worked out in the way that they did. Some of the challenges that you're moving through, yeah, have been really painful. They have required you to learn and grow. As much as life is about experience and adventure, we also need to evolve, right? We need to evolve past the point of limitation, you know, or just like the nature of life is to grow and evolve. Maharishi Mahesh said that. And it's so true. We find pain and suffering when we're trying to limit, resist those changes. And whether we like it or not, just in the collective right now, there's a lot changing. And there's also a lot in retrograde. And retrograde has a tendency to bring up those things that we don't necessarily want to look at. You're feeling a little bit unsteady, or maybe just like unsteady within yourself today. Not necessarily, oh, there's our perspective card. So double confirmation on the perspective. So unsteady in your perspective, right? It looks like things are like unfolding, happening, where it's forcing you 100%. It's forcing you to look at someone or something in a completely different way, with the Hangman and the Lovers at the bottom of the deck. It doesn't just have to be love. It's partnership of any kind. It can be a friend. It can be a business partner, a coworker. Take it how it fits, how it resonates for you. But things that are happening today are really kind of highlighting, showcasing some of the things that are going to challenge, right? Are going to force you to put into practice all you've been learning. I feel like you've been dealing with some heavier stuff, obviously, with this frozen lilac card. It's been pretty destabilizing is what I'm seeing. Like, I feel like you've either been dealing with this situation for a super long time, or it feels like there hasn't really been a lot of movement. It's felt really stagnant. And it's kind of made you feel a little bit untethered, right? Like, you don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know where to, quote unquote, place down your roots, because there's still a lot of uncertainty up in the air. But I'm hearing this in the way, yeah, of totally like disempowering yourself to some capacity. Not that you're intending to, but with this Ten of Wands, it is talking about a lot of stress, a lot of burden on your plate. And burden because of this situation, because it's like nothing's happening, right? It's causing more stress, more drama than what needs to be. You already know this, but at the same time, yeah, you're like ready to keep moving forward. However, this situation, this dynamic does need to be worked out, or it's headed in that direction. Everything kind of culminates. The energy's been very weird in the fact that things are taking a little bit longer to unfold, to manifest, to play out. And so, yeah, there is this need to be patient in the process. We've been seeing the Tower, actually it came up in our weekly reading, so definitely check it out if you're interested. I do feel like for some of you, there is a person, an individual, a situation that is trying to reconnect, restart over. I feel like this is someone who's coming in to bring in information, bring some clarity around maybe their feelings, their viewpoint, their perspective on a situation. This has been something that has been very difficult, like I said, very heavy, very burdensome. And I feel like to some capacity, both of you have had a hard time being more diplomatic in your perspective, right? Kind of, there's been a lot of emotion, like I've been talking about, but this feels like this has been going on longer than just the past few weeks. What I do like about today is there is a lot of earth element. So there's more of an opportunity to kind of find balance and grounding. And we also have a little fire in there. Pluto is actually ruled by Mars, or was back in the day. And so when we are uncovering what is triggering us, or the things that are making emotional, whether it works or not, the situations that are very overwhelming, very burdensome, that fire energy is giving us the passion to rise above. And thankfully, Mars is harmoniously aspected today to Neptune. And I really like that, because as much as maybe we don't want to make the changes right now, at the same time, there's so much benefit to doing so. And when we're able to kind of listen to our instincts, yeah, stay committed to that path, it's going to be revealed as time moves on. And this is showing today that there is more unfolding. There's more unfolding, and you feel, or something is making you want to self-protect today. This can be family, this can be home, this could even just be a job, like something that you're very committed to. We have the Hierophant, Four of Wands, and you feel like you need to self-protect. You feel like, someone wants something from you. I feel like they've been watching, they've been waiting kind of in the background for quite some time. This feels like a completely different situation from this past. I'm seeing a few things going on here where, I feel like something's really gonna challenge you today, or within the next couple days. It feels like it's forcing you to switch your perspective, right, on how things have been playing out, or maybe how you're showing up in a situation, in a dynamic, because you have been maybe a little bit untethered or not as analytical in your perspective. I do feel like someone is making you feel a little bit crazy, though, is what I'm hearing. And that's why it's been really challenging to find that grounding, find that stabilization and that support. But you have this kind of like magical energy coming in. As much as the Tower can be a little bit unwelcomed, at the same time, sometimes we need that path to be cleared in order to see better. And that's how I'm seeing this Tower manifest for you. As much as I feel like on some level, this is coming out of left field. You might not be expecting it 100%. You've been preparing for this for a while. You've been sensing into this. You've been feeling that something's happening behind the scenes with this person, with this situation. And Spirit is asking you to self-protect, because I do feel like there is going to be a little bit of a Tower moment. Remember that Mars and the Sun are resistant to that change. Remaining balanced even in the process. And I'm hearing this is like, don't act before you are certain. Because I feel like Temperance, there might be some things that are just, yeah, it's making you question your happiness. It's making you question if you really want to be engaged or involved in this dynamic. Something about it feels very overwhelming. Something about it feels like maybe you need to choose other options. But like I said, it is all about perception. It is about how you are seeing the situation, how you're seeing this individual. And I feel like some of the negative, some of the fear, some of the doubt is coming off these past experiences. Past experiences where people were supposed to support, where were supposed to bring in that reciprocity, and it just didn't happen. And you've had a lot of stress just getting out of this, starting over, finding new opportunities, new things to help you feel stable and supported. And I do feel like this past energy is lingering around. It's making you feel a little uncertain, not convinced as to how things are going to go. And both Jupiter and Neptune are resistant to our fortune right now. So it's going to kind of make things look as though it's not going to happen. It's not going to work out. Or you can't trust someone when in fact you can. It's super important to listen to your gut instincts. And like I was saying, don't react, right? Don't react until you know for certain. I feel like that's the whole point of just keeping yourself a little bit more grounded and stable, not getting too emotional about what is kind of playing out around you, especially when it doesn't directly affect you. Because I feel like some of this stuff that's happening around you, like I said, it's more of the opportunity to see that things might not be exactly what you think. To not take it personally, to not beat yourself up over it, over what is happening. Yeah, continuing to practice, continuing to put your best foot forward. That is kind of just the nature of mastery, practice over and over and over and over again. And there are some things that you're still feeling a little unsteady around, and that's where that practice is so important. We got this in our weekly reading as well. So we are really in this focus this week of removing blockages, removing our own mental, emotional blockages, things that have prevented you, limited you from being that best version or going after what you really want. And it's time to put it into practice, right? It's time to focus on what you have in front of you, to keep growing, to keep evolving, to not let the emotions, the burden, the stress overwhelm you. Easier said than done. But in my opinion, that's a lot about just being balanced in our day to day, you know, having that balance of activity and rest, making sure you're not overextending or becoming too lethargic, too apathetic, you know, really kind of finding a really good balance, a really good flow with how you're treating your mind, your body, your soul. That's going to make this refinement period that much easier, that much more successful. And places where you do have past energies lingering that you're releasing, letting go of, it's not going to feel as overwhelming because you have that strong stability, that strong support of your health and wellness. So I hope you enjoyed the reading today. Thank you so much for your time and energy always. I super appreciate you. Definitely drop comments below if it resonated. I always love to hear. Or just connect with you. Share in a little love, little TLC. I super appreciate all the love you bring to the channel. Know that I'm sending it back your way.